Yes. over their flock at night. And an angel of the Lord suddenly stood near them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terribly frightened. And so the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy, which will be for all the people. For today, in the city of David, there has been born for you a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find the baby wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there appeared with the angel a multitude of the heavenly army of angels, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among people with whom he is pleased." When the angel had departed from them into heaven, the shepherds began saying one to another, "Let us go straight to Bethlehem, then, and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." Luke 2:8-15.
Keep bringing the sheep. all who heard it was amazed by the things which were told them by the shepherds. But many treasured all these things and pondered them in their heart. And the shepherd went back, glorifying and praising God for all that they had heard and seen, just as had been told to them.
Yeah. Consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was upon him. And it had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death before he had seen the Lord's Christ.
And he came by the Spirit into the temple. And when the parents brought in the child Jesus to carry out for him the custom of the law, then he took him in his arms and blessed God and said, "Now, Lord, you are letting your bondservant depart in peace according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the presence of all the peoples, a light for revelation for the Gentiles and the glory of your people Israel." And his father and mother were amazed at the things which were being said about him. And Simeon blessed them and said to his mother Mary, "Behold, this child is appointed for the fall and rise of many in Israel, and as a sign to be opposed, and a sword will pierce your own soul, to the end that thoughts from many hearts may be revealed." And there was a prophetess, Anna, the daughter of Phanuel, of the tribe of Asher. She was advanced in years and had lived with her husband for 7 years after her marriage, and then as a widow to the age of 84. She did not leave the temple grounds, serving night and day with fasts and prayers. And at that very moment, she came up and began giving thanks to God and continued to speak about him to all those who were looking forward to the redemption of Jerusalem.
Yeah.
exalt you, my God, the King, and I will bless your name forever and ever. Every day I will bless you, and I will praise your name forever and ever. Great is the Lord, and highly to be praised, and his greatness is unsearchable. One generation will praise your works to another, and I will declare your mighty acts. On the glorious splendor of your majesty, and on your wonderful works, I will meditate. People will speak of the power of your awesome acts, and I will tell of your greatness. They will burst forth in speaking of your abundant goodness, and will shout joyfully of your righteousness.